Hi all. Today we'll discuss about the initial page load using SSR, server-side rendering. Before discussing this, we need to understand the importance of initial page load time. Any of the website we are giving to the customers, it should load as soon as possible. It should be faster. If not, 40% of the users before loading that page, they will abandon it and they will come out. And the rest of the percent of the users will not come to our website for the next time. So we need to understand the importance of page load time, the first initial page load. In this video, I'm concentrating on the first initial page load, not on the web performance things. So only by increasing the initial page load time, the Walmart e-commerce website has increased their business with 1% sales. So for every 100 milliseconds of improvement in the website initial page load, they could able to gain and grow up their revenue by 1%. So with this slide, we can understand the importance of initial page load, which will increase the business and the sales. So before understanding this server-side rendering, we need to understand what is exactly the client-side rendering, which we are using for React.js and Angular.js currently. So the client-side rendering, if you look into this picture, the user opens any browser. The server will directly throw away the bundle JS files. If you request any of the requests, the server just throws the bundle file JS. So now it's time for the client browser. This browser needs to start the parsing of the HTML file and thereafter the JS file. And it needs to parse the JS file, and thereafter it needs to get into the React.js code. So the React.js code browser can't understand. Browser only understands the JavaScript, plain JavaScript, HTML and CSS. Now this React.js code should be converted and translated by Babel into plain JavaScript code. So all this work will be continued on the client browser. So all these three steps needs to be happen before the page is loaded. So these are the three phases in client-side rendering. So the loading, skeleton, and the full rendered page. It takes long time. The initial load would be very long in the client-side rendering. So suppose we understand, now we understand, if you understand the problem, if there are any weaker devices, like if the client machine is very weak device, like if he has very poor internet connection, he thinks that our website is waste and he will not return back to our website for the initial load. So if his internet connection is poor, if he has full RAM, if he has low RAM and low ROM, even all these we are considering as a weaker devices. So the people who has all these type of things, they think that our website is not performing well. So why we need to do all these things at the client side browser? If we do all the rendering parsing at the client browser, it takes much time, more time. So the clients and the users will get bad experience about our website. How about the idea that we do all those parsing and everything, and just we throw back the plain HTML, CSS, JavaScript to our clients, so that if the clients have the weaker devices or less internet, poor internet connections as well, he will directly get the plain HTML and CSS, JavaScript files to him, and his client browser can understand them, so it will directly parse that pages. So that's called as server-side rendering. If you understand this image, the user is opening a website. This is a server-side build. So now the server will understand what he needs, and server will parse all his requests, and it will just return the plain HTML, CSS, JavaScript to the client. So as soon as the client gets these HTML, CSS, JavaScript into it, it will start parsing and it will render the page. So by this, in the second step only, the user will get that website page, initial load page, which is viewable, but it is not interactable. To interact, he needs to have all the bindings, everything needs to be connected. So here the points to understand. For every e-commerce websites these days, like Walmart and Amazon, they are going with server-side rendering because it impacts their business and sales a lot. So the good thing is, anyone who knows React.js, the client-side rendering, they are ready to start their server-side rendering. There is a framework called Next.js, which is built on top of React.js, which is supporting the server-side rendering. So you can directly start up server-side rendering if you're good at React.js. So the conclusion parts or the server-side rendering setup is very cost. Like server-side setup is very costed. So we need to understand if it is cost as well, it increases the business. So we need to understand both differences and we need to have a setup. And concluding to the server-side rendering, for better customer experience, to improve the sales, for the best SEO results, we need to go with the server-side rendering. One more thing, if the page is loading very slow, the conversion rate and the bouncy rate, there will be many things involved in SEO, like conversion rate, bouncy rate. If any users comes to our website and he's not clicking anything and he's closing our website, the bouncy rate would be increasing. Thereafter, the Google norms, as per the Google norms, if the bouncy rate for any website increases, it will not show our website in the subsequent search results. So by that, our website goes to the lost position. So we need to understand, with the help of this server-side rendering, the SEO results also would be very fine. So from now, I think in the e-commerce applications or any of your applications before developing, please understand the initial page load importance and try to build the website with the initial page load. Thanks for watching.